Hello all, I welcome you for 1 week faculty development program on e-content development and effective use of ICT. We are going to discuss about online delivery of contents, and in the last video we have started with Google Meet. Today we are going to discuss how to schedule a Google Meet and how to invite the participants for that meeting. For that we need to go to the Google Calendar app. For that, just click on these 9 dots and select calendar from here. Once the calendar is loaded, we can schedule the meeting as per the date and time. I will select 14 June. Just click at that time instant and this pop-up will appear. Here we can give the title for this meeting, demo meeting. The date and time, we can just change the timing also from here, and we can invite the guests from here by using their email addresses. This is my another email address I am going to use as participant and join with the Google Meet. If you are able to see here that it is saying up to 250 participants, because as a host I am going to use this as my email account, kunal.khadke@modernCoE.edu.in. It belongs to Google Suite account, that's why I am able to invite 250 participants for this meeting. Otherwise it allows only 100 participants. Here two options are there: either we can add locations or we can add descriptions if it is required, and this we can save. Your meeting is scheduled, but there are few more options we need to discuss. Click on more options, and this is the meeting details. If this meeting we are going to schedule for my TE class, suppose. So, and if I want any PPT file to share with the students, so I can click over here, add attachment. And we can select the file from Google Drive, or I can directly upload a file from my host machine. So select your device and I will upload this file. Just click on upload. Now this file will be shared with all the participants in this meeting, and just I will say save the schedule. It will just ask me that we need to send this invitations to Google Calendar. I will say send. The participant which I have added, it is not belongs to the Google Suite of my organization, that's why this window is there. So I will say invite external guests. Now this window is occurred because I am trying to share one file with the participants. So turn sharing on and invite. Now the meeting is scheduled. Now I have opened my another account in the Firefox browser. So to avoid the confusion, I am trying to use two browsers. In the Google Chrome I am going to use as a host account, and from Firefox browser I am going to use as a participant account. So in the participant account we have received the invitation mail. So demo meeting, date and time, who is the host for this meeting. I will say yes, no, or maybe. So click on yes, and this is the link to join for this meeting. So I will start this meeting first. So go to the host, just go to the meet.google.com. Here we will just see the meeting because it is already scheduled, and I will just say join now. I will turn off my camera and microphone. Getting ready now, ready to join. Join now. So this is the host side and the discussion room is created, but right now there is a single participant, that is host. Now we will go to the participant account and I will just click on that link. I will again turn off my camera and microphone to avoid the echo, and I will say join now. The participant is added. If you are able to see here, now there are two participants for this meeting. I will again go back to the host account. So one more option we need to discuss in this video is record meeting. So just click on these three dots and you will find the record meeting option over here. If your host account belongs to Google Suite, then you will able to see this option, record meeting. If you are not using any G Suite account, this option is not there for that account. So I will say record meeting. Before starting the recording, it will ask for a consent of the participants. I will say accept and the recording will be started. The recording is started. The participants can also able to see that the host is recording by checking this symbol. Now, at the time of scheduling this meeting, we have shared one file with the participant. So we can also check that file is shared or not. So just click on this attachment, and in this over here in this tab, attachments tab, we can able to see that file which we have already shared with the participant. Now the meeting is going on. At that time, if the host wants to remove the participant or any participants wants to remove, just click on this remove button, that person or participants can be removed from this meeting, or they can use this pin to screen function. If you click on this button or if this tab, so the participant's screen will be visible to the host. Now I will just turn off the recording, or I will stop the recording. While stopping the recording, it will ask that the recording will be saved to the Google Drive of the host account. So I have just said stop, the recording will be saved to the Google Drive. So we'll just check that if this recording is saved or not. So go to the Google Drive, just refresh this. It will take some time. So meanwhile, we will just stop this meeting. So I will say end this call and close this meeting. And from host side also, I will just close this meeting. Now we will go to the drive again. Refresh. It will take some time, and once the recording is ready, again you will receive the mail that the recording is saved to the Google Drive. So in the next video, we are going to discuss about how to take attendance of the participant, and one more video we are going to discuss about how to use whiteboard in Google Meet. This is taking too much time, so I will stop this video. Thank you.